Hi, Jerry.
How are you?
A little tired between your paper and the preparations for Sukkot.
I know. This is the net result after about 40 hours of singing over the last 2 weeks,
yeah.
And then we had Hebrew school this morning, and the kids, they were putting up the sukkah, and the kids were making decorations for the sukkah, and we were singing, and I'm like, a little spaced out already, you know.
Last night, 11 o'clock at night, they came to put my sukkah up.
Oy vey. At least you have somebody to put it up. I mean,
yeah.
We have some of the men from the shul do it, but they're not the handiest, you know. So it's almost painful to watch. You know, it's kind of like, oh boy, who's going to get hurt this year in the sukkah, you know?
I have a guy. He's a caterer in the shul. He's also my handyman. He's a jack of all trades. So he prepares all the food for me. We don't cook much anymore. He does everything in the house for me.
Well, that's great. That's great. Send them up here. I could use his help. Well. How are things down there, dare I ask?
We have a crazy governor. The rabbi announced in our shul, no more masking, no more social, everything. We're going to have community meals, everything, because the governor said it's safe.
Oy vey. Oy.
And the rabbi he had a breakthrough COVID infection, which he just got over.
Oh my God. I mean, that's the thing. I mean, look, this is restating the obvious, but here, I've mentioned before, we had these debates back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. We ended up almost all of our services, the children's services were outdoors. We held the children's services outdoors, and none of the kids were really, who were not of vaccination age, were permitted in for the regular services. So we did the children's services outdoors, and that worked out okay. We were fortunate with the weather. The weather held up. The other services, including a last Friday night's Shabbat service and the previous Friday for Shabbat Shuva, we got very light turnout in person. We got a lot of people on Zoom, and the interesting part, I think, is going to be, we've come to realize, obviously, in an Orthodox setting, it's a totally different problem. But, on the one hand, we realized early on that this is a component we really needed to have anyway, before COVID. You know what I mean? We had homebound people, we had people that can't drive at night, all those things. And we have an older congregation. So there really needs to be this component of being able to at least watch, whether it's live streamed or it's Zoomed or whatever. The problem, if you want to look at it that way, and it may be a problem, is that I think a lot of people got used to it. And so now it's kind of like, well, why even bother to get dressed up to come to shul on Friday night or to rush home from work and rush over to eat and rush over to shul? I can just sit down on my couch and Jerry and the rabbi will entertain me. That's the other side of the double-edged sword, that it really, there is that. I suppose in one sense, as long as, from the administration's point of view, I guess people's attitude as well, as long as they continue to pay the dues, it's okay, But look, it's like everything else. Look, I try to explain to people if it was just, and these circumstances, of course, are very different than normal, right? Well, normally on Saturday morning you'd be going to shul, right? Or normally on Chagim you'd be going to shul, right? Here you can't. So, okay, so here you pray at home. You have your prayer book. You have your machzor. You do what you do. Fine, but the whole premise, the underlying premise of having a minyan is communal prayer. It's like communal singing, right? I mean, it's the same thing. It's not the same as phoning it in. And so there's always a danger to this type of thing, for people. For me, look, for me, quite frankly, I've said to people, I consider myself one of the luckiest people who throughout this pandemic because I continued to work and all of this music. I've literally played more music in this last year and a half than I've probably played in the last 10 years. And when will I get to see you? Once every once in a while when I come down to Florida, right? This is great. I mean, this is great. And I've met wonderful musicians and wonderful people, and that never would have happened, So I think this is really cool. And I'm sort of hoping, they're saying that they're working on the latency problem and that eventually they'll figure out how people can play together online simultaneously. And when they figure that out, boy, you'll be able to play with people all over the world. It'll be great.
Somebody has a whistle. You know, they don't let him walk.
We should turn it a little.
I think you had a little high volume, Harvey. We're getting an echo from you.
From who?
You, as soon as you came on.
Echo.
Echo?
You sure it's not me?
You sound fine.
Okay.
Something just stopped.
Yeah, okay, now it's okay.
Muted. Is it back again?
Yeah.
Yeah. There's a hum in the back.
Yeah. It's coming from yours.
But I hear notes of something being strummed.
That was me.
Oh, okay.
My hand does it by itself. I don't.
Well, that's convenient. You don't even have to learn how to play.
All I do is crank Mickey's tail. The music comes right out, you know?
So can you hear me now?
Yeah, yeah. It sounds clear.
Okay.
Okay, because I just lowered my volume a little bit.
Okay, yeah, that's good, yeah. Again, my feedback.
Okay, so Saul, do you want us to record?
Yes, let me take care of that now. By the way, Pat, you're not completely in the picture. Yeah, half of you, well, now it's better. Yeah. Part of your face wasn't.
If I move over, the guitar is going to be in the way.
I don't want it to be too close. She impinges upon the body of the guitar.
Oh. Got to get one of those short neck guitars.
Do you have confirmation that you can record?
What'd you say?
You have the confirmation that you can record?
Yes.
Yes, he's good.
Okay.
It's currently turned on but paused.
Okay.
So if you shift your chair just a little, then you won't run into me.
If you lower that arm, I might not run into you either.
That's a good idea. There you go.
There you go.
All right. We're all set.
I gotta get one of the Water Magic guitars that plays itself like you have, Jerry.
Absolutely the best investment I ever made.
True. It plays so fancy too, and you don't have to do it.
It has different settings, you know? Fancy, sloppy, you know? Too loud. It's
good. No, the only setting my guitar has is sloppy.
Well, you see, you didn't get the deluxe model. That's like my friend who bought the car that doesn't come with turn signals, you know? He got the economy model.
Used to use the old hand signals. People forgot how to use them now. You had to know them in order to pass the driving test.
Nobody knows those hand signals anymore.
He uses hand signals, his middle finger. That's the hand signals. He's dangerous.
He can get you into trouble in New York.
Yeah, he used to carry around a bag of old golf balls and threaten people with them as he drove by. You know, he's a scary guy. Let me tell you, a Brooklyn kid. You understand?
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't understand that. I don't know no Brooklyn guys.
But I knew a Brooklyn guy who lived above me, away, and then subsequently he died. But he used to carry a hatchet under his dashboard, and if he got real angry at somebody, he would pick up the hatchet like he was going to come out and kill them.
I used to work on 67th Street in Central Park West in New York, and I had a late shift. By the way, that's ABC Television, in case you're curious. And I'd get off at like 2:33 in the morning. So I used to get dressed in blue jeans and an army fatigue shirt, and I slid a length of stainless steel rod about that long up my sleeve and carried a book in my hand. And when I left the shift and walked up Central Park West to get to my car, I put the book in my back pocket and put the stainless steel rod in my right hand. I never saw anybody.
Precautions pay off. They do. That was a tough neighborhood, let me tell you, back in the day.
Oh, yeah, guys on that same shift used to get robbed all the time. Yeah. There's a strange thing, you put a $20 bill and no credit cards in your wallet. When they stick the gun in your face, you open the wallet, they take the 20 and they leave.
Especially at night, I mean, to walk through the park at night, even now, is dangerous. You know, it's taking your life in your hands.
Oh, so I was talking about, 2-3 in the morning.
Yeah.
That's when the late shift gets off. Mm-hmm. But like I said, I never saw anybody. I'd get to my car and I'd throw the piece of stainless steel rod into the back seat, drive away.
You're lucky your car was still there.
You couldn't steal it. I had an electric fuel pump with a switch. And I had another switch that turned the battery off. That was located under the dash. I push a button under the dashboard. There was no battery in the car. You couldn't do anything but tow it.
I had a bunch of gigs in the city, and I used to drive in, and I kept hoping somebody would steal my car. You know, I always come back and be disappointed the car was still there. You know?
That's what my son was like, because he had a Ford. He had a Ford, Ford Focus. He bought it new. And every other day, practically, something or other broke down on that car. He had his transmission kaput about two times. He had door trouble, and everything that could go
wrong. You understand what Ford stands for, right?
Wait, I heard.
Fix or repair daily.
That's unbelievable.
You see, that's when you buy a car from the guy who was an anti-Semite originally.
I don't.
Somebody is asking me for the link, so let me see if I can get him on, okay?
What?
Someone is, new guy's asking for the link.
Oh, Ford.
So, we'll start the 2 minutes as soon as I get the link there. Okay, 1 second. I may have to go off for a second. So just keep it where it is a second.
But speaking of cars left out to be stolen, I know somebody who had a real bad vehicle, lived in Brooklyn, and left it parked on the street with the keys in it, hoping it would be stolen. Mm. Nobody else wanted it either.
I'm recording, so I can't get him the link at all. Here, it's out of luck. Here, I can't. Once I start, I can't stop in the middle. So let's start. We have a minion now. Okay, here's the here is the order: Jerry, Pat, Harvey, Murray, Bob Winkler, Kathleen, Bob and Susan, Mike Reeves, Bill Pardon, Steve Einbinder, and Lonnie. Okay, that's the link. That's what we have so far.
After Kathleen, it's Mike.
After Kathleen, it's Bob.
We usually put on
Bob and Susan.
Mike. We put on participants. Oh. Really? Take off chat.
It's written down there.
Oh, you got it.
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
Yeah. Okay, so let's start. Jerry, you are with someone. Let's contact me on chat here.
Mute us.
Okay, so everybody knew Jerry came in first.
Okay.
Jerry.
I probably will have to run off in a little while and then come back, hopefully. But anyway, as I said to Saul, this is what's left over after about 35 or 40 hours of singing over the last 2 weeks. And Hebrew school this morning. But so this song seems totally appropriate because this was the first thing I did when I came home from Yom Kippur services after singing for 7 hours, straight for the wine bottle. So. Bottle of wine through the vine. When you gonna let me get sober? Let me alone. Let me go home. let me go back and start over. Rambling around this dirty old town, singing for nickels and dimes. Time's getting rough, I ain't got enough to buy me a bottle of wine. Bottle of wine, fruit of the vine. When you gonna let me get sober? Let me alone, let me go home. Let me go back and start over. Little hotel, older than hell, cold and dark as a mine. Blanket so thin I lay there and grin, but I got me a bottle of wine. Bottle of wine, fruit of the vine. When you gonna let me get sober? Let me alone, let me go home. Let me go back and start over. Start over. Ache in my head and bugs in my bed. Pants are so old that they shine. Out on the street, I tell the people I meet, buy me a bottle of wine. Bottle of wine, fruit of the vine. When you gonna let me get sober? Let me alone, let me go home. Let me go back and start over. Preacher will preach and the teacher will teach. Miner will dig in the mine. I ride the rods, trusting in God, but clutching my bottle of wine. Bottle of wine, fruit of the vine. When you gonna let me get sober? Let me alone, let me go home. Let me go back and start over. Get a drink.
Okay, Pat, you're next, then Harvey.
Thank you. We're gonna do In My Life. It was written by the Beatles and sung by many people.
There are places I remember. Some have changed forever, not for better. Some have gone, and some remain. All these places have their moments. With lovers and friends, I still can recall. Some are dead and some are living. In my life, I love. But of all these friends and lovers, there is no one compares with you. And this memory serves their meaning. When I think of love as something new, I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before. I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love you more. Oh, I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before. I know I'll often stop and think about them in my life, I love you more. In my life, I love you
more. Well, let's see. I haven't played this one in a while. So I'm going to give it a shot and hope that my flat pick actually finds the appropriate strings as I try to get fancy and possibly fail miserably. It's called Moonshadow.
Oh, I'm being followed by a moonshadow. Leaping to hop in on a moon shadow. And if I ever lose my head, lose my high plow, lose my land. Yes, if I ever lose my head, no, I won't have to work no more. And if I ever lose my head, if my colors all run dry, yes, if I ever lose my head, oh yeah, I won't have to cry no more. Cause I'm being followed by a moon shadow, leaping and hopping on a moon shadow. And if I ever lose my legs, I won't own and I won't beg. As if I ever lose my legs, oh yeah, I won't have to walk no more. And if I ever lose my mouth, all my teeth, the whole head south. As if I ever lose my mouth, oh yeah. Take long to find me, nice faithful life. And did it take long to find me, and are you gonna stay tonight? I'm being followed by a moon shadow. Leaping and hopping on a moon shadow.
Thank you, Harvey. I want to welcome Andy Hagen to the group. Andy, are you going to perform or are you just listening? You just unmute and tell us yes or no. Will you be performing, Andy? Okay, if not, I'm just going to, he's probably just listening, so just assume that he's not performing unless he tells me later. Okay, Murray, you're next.
Okay. I think about two sessions ago, we were talking about Ladino music. So I just happened to come across a couple of Ladino songs and I'm going to sing them. I'll sing one at a time, of course. It's very hard to sing two songs at the same time. All right. The first one is called Durme Durme. That means sleep. And you know, Ladino is an old form of Spanish. It's the Spanish, for the most part, it's the foundation of it is the Spanish that people talked in Spain at the time of Columbus, which was also the same year that the Jews were kicked out of Spain and had to go all around the Mediterranean world and even also across the sea to South America and that type of thing. But anyway, here's the song, Durme, Durme. Durme, durme, mi alma doncella. Durme, durme, sin ansia y dolor. Durme, durme, sin ansia y dolor. Que tu esclavo que tanto desea ver tu sueño con grande amor. Ver tu sueño con grande amor. Hay 2 años que sufre mi alma. Por ti yo ya, mi linda dama. Por ti yo ya, mi linda dama. Siente, siente al son de mi guitarra, siente hermosa mis males cantar, siente hermosa mis males cantar. Durme, durme, mi alma doncella, durme, durme, sin ansia y dolor, durme, durme, sin ansia y dolor. That's the end of the song, but I'll give you the English translation first. Which I should have done in the first place. But the song goes, sleep, sleep, my beloved damsel, sleep, sleep, without anxiety or pain, sleep, sleep, without anxiety or pain. Here is your slave who wishes a lot to watch over your sleep with the greatest of love, to watch over your sleep with the greatest of love. For 2 years, my soul is suffering because of you, my jewel, my beautiful lady. Because of you, my jewel, my beautiful lady. Listen, listen to my guitar. Listen, beautiful lady, my evils to sing. Listen, beautiful lady, my evils to sing. Anyway, that's the song.
Thank you, Marty. Now we're moving from Brooklyn all the way out to Arizona and Bob Winkler.
Thank you, Saul. Okay. Getting over something I've had for the last few days. Trying to get the voice back in shape, but we'll try it. Anyway, weather report. It's about 78 degrees, about 40% humidity. It was about 100% this morning. We had our once a year fog, really unusual to have fog here, but we had it this morning. Couldn't see across the street. Wine anytime, night or day. Only trouble is, gee whiz, I'm dreaming my life away. Need you so that I could die. Love you so, and that is why whenever I want you, all I have to do is dream, 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 dream. When I feel blue in the night, when I need you to hold me tight, whenever I want you, all I have to do is dream. I can make you mine, taste your lips of wine, anytime, night or day. All the trouble is, gee whiz, I'm dreaming my life away.
Sal, you asked me about one of the kids in our yeshiva who used to sing this song a lot. And yep. Yeah, I remember it. And he used to always do it with a European R. Dream, 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 dream.
Right. Yeah. Okay, next is Kathleen, you're next.
Okay, thank you. I've got a cousin in Wales that I have little sort of FaceTime sing and play alongs with, and I often play what I'm going to play here, and he's accused me of always having a miserable song, and I think it's because I only like miserable song. But I was looking at all the songs tonight and I thought, well, they're not all miserable, and I did like them, so it's just me. So this song it's not really miserable. It's written by a couple that I found on lockdown called Honey and the Bear, and they live in Suffolk. And they write a lot of songs about where they live. And this is a song about a lady, I've forgotten her name. I think her name was Irish Bishop. And she was born in Argentina, and she survived 3 shipwrecks. And she ended up living in Suffolk. So that's why, near them, that's why they wrote the song about her. And the second song, the second boat she was on was the Titanic, but she survived 3 shipwrecks. And the third one was in the war when she was, I don't know what she was doing exactly, but she was in the war. And anyway, she survived them all, and she ended up living in Suffolk. So it's, I suppose it's sort of sad, but it's a happy ending. Called The Hungry Sea. I remember the day I boarded that vessel fine and fair. Rich men dressed in their finery, a humble maiden mine. There was humming expectation of the journey yet to be, as we sailed into the everlasting blue that was the sea. And it wasn't long, no, it wasn't long, before the energy around me turned to fear. As the ship went down, how the horn did sound. I remember thinking, this is it for me. That I would float to the center of this deep and hungry sea, I would close my eyes and pray, and eventually the Savior came for me, just me, just me. I was in great need of the money when the next job came along. Up a ship ramp I did climb again, the chambermaid once more. I had no fear of it floundering, for it couldn't possibly happen twice in one mate's lifetime when the shipmates knew the sea. But it wasn't long before I was proved wrong, and the ship's song sounded late into the night. As the ship went down, in the dark I held, I remember thinking, this is it for me. But I would float to the center of this deep and hungry sea. I would close my eyes and pray, and eventually the Savior came for me. When they called, I did my service on a naval ship. When torpedoes came, we floundered in the sea. The propeller nearly crushed us with its mighty weight. Once again, never again. But I would float to the center of this deep and hungry sea. I would close my eyes and pray, and eventually the Savior came for me. Just me, just me, just me.
That's it.
Now, is the air conditioner off, Bob?
The air conditioner. How embarrassing.
Hey, it's 88 degrees, you know.
Florida again, okay.
How can I keep from singing? My life flows on in endless song, above earth's lamentation. I hear the real, though far off, hymn that hails the new creation. No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging. It sounds an echo in my soul. How can I keep from singing? What though the tempest loudly roars? I know the truth it liveth. What though the darkness round me close? Songs in the night it giveth. No storm can shake
my innermost come, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing? When tyrants tremble sick with fear and hear their death knells ringing, when friends rejoice both far and near, how can I keep from singing? In prison cell and dungeon vile, our thoughts to them are winging. When friends by shame are undefiled, how can I keep from singing?
Started a little low, didn't I?
Yeah, you did. But it's all right, honey. I can handle it.
Well, when I heard Harvey and Pat were going to do a Beatles song, I thought they were going to do one of the two that I was going to do this week, and they didn't. And so I'm going to folkify a couple of Beatles songs that I always liked and just never really learned.
Bob,
so
Bob, if you give me a chance, I'll do a couple of those songs just to preempt you.
Thanks, Harvey. Always a friend.
Always.
Yeah.
Okay, going back across the Atlantic again from Florida to England, and Mike Reeves.
Yeah. Yeah, on the theme of songs that the Floor Spots did at in the Hoy Tuesday. This is the Tuesday before. This is Dave Simons did. And I hope it's not too insensitive for what's going on in New Orleans, but it's about a similar happening in 1927, so it shows it's not a new occurrence. What has happened down here is the wind has changed. Clouds rolled in from the north and it started to rain. Rained real hard and rained for a real long time. 6 feet of water in the streets of Evangeline. The river rose all day, the river rose all night. Some people got lost in the flood, some people got away all right. The river had busted through clear down to the Plaquemines. 6 feet of water in the streets of Evangeline. Louisiana, Louisiana, they're trying to wash us away. They're trying to wash us away. Louisiana, Louisiana, they're trying to wash us away. They're trying to wash us away. President Coolidge came down in a railroad train with a little fat man with his notepad in his hand. The president said, little fat man, isn't it a shame what the river has done to this poor cracker's land? Louisiana, Louisiana, they're trying to wash us away. They're trying to wash us away. Louisiana, Louisiana, they're trying to wash us away. 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 Louisiana, 1927.
I never heard that one before. There was a
song. Oh, Randy Newman.
Huh?
Randy, it was written by Randy Newman.
Randy Newman.
And he said his mother's from New Orleans. Uh-huh. And he said, they're great at food and music, but not so good at civil engineering.
Yeah, Mike, did you put in a yellow bulb above you? Because you're...
No, it's just...
The whole
no, I think it's... I don't know what it is, yeah.
Yeah, the whole town is yellowish.
Soft glow, yes, I know, I've got that, yeah.
Yeah.
I know Bill Staines had a song called Louisiana Storm. I remember that one, but I never heard this one before. Okay, we're going to remember now. Bill Podden is next.
Hello again. I'm wearing the hat as my small concession to International Talk Like a Pirate Day. That's about as far as it will go. I do run around all day saying, pretty Polly, pretty Polly, pieces of eight, but it doesn't get me anywhere. So it's an American invention anyway, that Talk Like a Pirate Day, you know. It's you lot to blame for that. But, anyway, I've got words today, and I've even got them all rigged up, and I've got it in a great big font because I can't read much from a distance anyway, and I've put all sorts of little notes so I can put in hummy bits and harmonic bits so I've got time to read the next verse before I get to it. But it's a song I haven't done for so many years. But it's comes from a little coastal village in Cornwall called Zenor, and they got a very picturesque little church there. And if you walk to the very front of the church, they got very ornate carvings at the end of all the different pews. But at the very front pew, there's a carving of a mermaid, and she's a very famous mermaid in those parts, the Mermaid of Zenor, who was said to have been stumbled across by the local vicar who heard her singing. Thought she had such a beautiful voice, he invited her up to his church, that one before. And anyway, she got to church and she enticed one of the young men away because he was also a wonderful singer, and he ran away to sea with her and lived under the waves and They all lived happily ever after, I believe. But this is the story of the Mermaid of Zinor. If I get to the other end of it, anything's possible. Yeah, sounds about right. In Zenora's old church, she is carved in a pew, the mermaid whose story is said to be true, of how the vicar went walking one fine summer's day, on the beach, on the beach, on the beach by the bay. There a soft voice was singing a wonderful song, as the vicar went walking along. A sound of such wonder no distance away, on the beach, on the beach, on the beach by the bay. A beautiful mermaid discovered he there, and surely no maiden was ever so fair. He fell to his knees as if making to pray, on the beach, the beach by the bay. He spoke to her there on her high rocky perch, politely inviting her into his church. And surely enough, on the next Sabbath day, she came up from the beach by the bay. The mermaid was welcomed by one and by all, and she sang to her god with a voice to enthrall. And magically charmed and enraptured were they in the church overlooking the bay. Young Matthew Trefella was handsome and bold, singing the hymns with a voice rich as gold. But his eyes to the mermaid would constantly stray as he stood in the church overlooking the bay. Now Matthew Trehella had ended his search, the love of his life he had found in this church, and now he must claim her without a delay, in the church overlooking the bay. But after the service the mermaid must go back down to the sea where it sparkled below, and Matthew Trehella could no longer stay, and he ran from the church heading down to the bay. He ran through the fields her steep pathway to find. She cast him a glance as he stumbled behind, and Matthew Trehella would soon feel the spray from the waves in the bay. And into the water with laughter and joy the mermaid swam out, followed by her sweet boy. That very same evening together they lay in the waves, the waves in the bay. Now many years after a ship there was hove at anchor far out along deep Endor Cove, when a golden-haired being with words she must say emerged from the waves of the bay. Captain, oh captain, a favour I crave, your anchor is blocking the door to my cave. My children are needing to feed and to play in the waves, the waves of the bay. Now Matthew Trehella was seen nevermore, but often sweet singing is heard from the shore. A rising duet on a clear summer's day from the waves of the bay. And many a tale has been told ever since of a mermaid princess and her handsome young prince. But to Zenor one day will they once again stray, to the church overlooking the bay. In Zenor for sure you will see them one day, in the church of old Zenor Bay. That's the magical mermaid of Zenor. That's all you get.
Great.
Okay, next we go to back to South Florida, Steve Eigenbinder. Okay, Lonnie, get ready, you're next.
As you know, I have to switch to my guitar-friendly chair. On my Zoom in gallery view, I thought Lonnie was before me, but that's okay. I will do two parts here. The part of the young lady that's being courted by the Buffalo Boy, and the Buffalo Boy himself. When are we gonna marry, to marry, to marry? When are we gonna marry, dear old Buffalo Boy? I guess we'll marry in a week, in a week, in a week. I guess we'll marry in a week, that is if the weather be good. How you gonna come to the wedding, the wedding, the wedding? How you gonna come to the wedding, dear old Buffalo Boy? I guess I'll come in my ox cart, my ox cart, my ox cart. I guess I'll come in my ox cart, that is if the weather be good. Why don't you bring your buggy, your buggy, your buggy? Why aren't you coming, your buggy, dear old Buffalo Boy? My ox won't fit in a buggy, in a buggy, in a buggy. My ox won't fit in a buggy, not even if the weather be good. Who are you gonna bring to the wedding, the wedding, the wedding? Who are you gonna bring to the wedding, dear old Buffalo Boy? I guess I'll bring my children, my children, my children. I guess I'll bring my children, that is if the weather be good. I didn't know you had no children, no children, no children. I didn't know you had no children, dear old Buffalo Boy. Why, sure, I've got five children, five children, five children. Why, sure, I've got five children, six if the weather be good. There ain't gonna be no wedding, no wedding, no wedding. There ain't gonna be no wedding, not even if the weather be good.
Really good.
That Gene Ritchie had a similar song but with different words. Somebody knows. Okay, I heard that last on Oscar Brand many years ago on this program. Okay, Lonnie, are you ready for us?
I believe I am. Can you hear me? Okay, good. Now I'm going to do a folk song. I did this in order to atone for the classical piece I did last week. And here we go. I'm even using a pick. So I've actually taken my pick here. You know. Well, it's my turn again, so I hope I won't flub. This song I made up for the Boca Folk Club. And you don't have to listen, so please have no fear. Just head out to your galley and chug a cold beer. Well, Sol is a tolerant fellow so far. He even forgave last week's Bach on guitar. But today I decided not to push my pluck. Now here's a real folk song. Wish me good luck. Well, the time is plenty, 'cause this is the world's longest song. Well, nobody can sing it because it's so long. Nobody can sing it or remember how it goes. So I'll just sing the first 100 verses or so. Well, the content is childish and it's not very deep. And anyone listening may soon fall asleep. All those who stay conscious will surely be bored. And all those who don't will be poked if they snore. Well, the melody starts here and then it goes low. And the second lung higher and ends up like so. Well, the third line is similar, but not quite the same. And the fourth line is just like the first line again. Well, it's dull and redundant, and it repeats itself. And it's dull and redundant and repeats itself. It just says the same thing all over and then. It just says the same thing all over again. It was handed down to me from my great-granddaddy's time. My grandfather continued, but he couldn't make it sound right. My father thought up a lot of words, but he just couldn't seem to get them all to fit. So he left it to me, and now I'm stuck with it. Well, now I'm working on it, but I'm pretty dense. I just haven't got any rhythmical sense. And after I croak, it'll go to my son. Which may prove problematic because I haven't got one. Now nobody can sing it, though many have tried. One feller swore that he could, but he lied. When the 489th verse came around, he got queasy and shaky, and he had to lie down. Well, there once was an old man who really could sing. And he quite nearly finished the whole goddamn thing. When he came to the last verse, he swelled up with pride. And he stammered and choked and exploded and died. Now, some idiot on Facebook said this song is all fluff. I should put in some socially redeeming stuff. Some truth and high consciousness, I said, gee whiz. That'll make it more boring than it already is. But just to be fair and to make everything right, I hummed out the one line that wasn't polite. It was crude and profane and contained dirty words. Was the you ever heard? But I saved all those offensive verses and stuff. And I made up an objectionable ballad, yuck, yuck. To embarrass a dock rat and make him upchuck. Tune in again next week. My new song really sucks. But I digress. There's a version here somewhere I can't quite recall. There's one line I just can't remember at all. And part of another that I... Well, the time's finally come, like in every dumb song, when all are coerced into singing along. But learning the chorus should not be a chore, 'cause it's all parts of songs that you've all heard before. Ready? Twirl-eye, url-eye, url-eye. Hey diddle, diddle, the dilly-dally day. Hickory dickory fiddly I-O. Chug chug toot toot clang 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 E-I-O. All right. All right. That's it. Come back into the room now.
That's funny.
Did you all enjoy your beer?
Very clever, Lonnie. I enjoyed it. Very clever.
Thank you. That's more than it deserves.
Okay, now
we take it back.
Debbie and Ron is next. And I see, I just needed the tip of Ron's hair over there. So I know he's in the picture somewhere. Yeah, unmute, Debbie.
Okay,
you got it.
All right, I haven't sung this in a very long time. Yeah, I need to remember we're a country of immigrants. I'm going to sing it in a different key, as my voice becomes more of a tenor than an alto. So hopefully I will get all the chords right. Well, my name is Juan, and I come to this country on a boat lift from Mario Bay. As I walked out the streets of the city, I heard some people say, they all look funny and they don't speak English. They're taking our jobs away. Then from out of the past I heard people who came to an island in New York. Ellis Island, come down the bin plane, go through the door, stand on the long, long line. Do you have TB or a social disease? Do your hands and your legs run fine? Do you have some relative there on the shore who can vouch for your sanity? If you make it through the day, they will stamp your card and say, welcome to the land of the free. Oh, my name is Pat, and I came from Killarney, where I worked with both of my hands. Then the crops, they failed, and the agent came, and he flew me off the island. So I crossed the ocean with my pack on my back, and I hope they will let me stay. Now the old world is gone, I can see a new home from this island in New York. Ellis Island, go down the gangplank, go through the door, stand on the long, long line. Do you have TB or a social disease? Do your hands and your legs work fine? Do you have some relative there on the shore who can vouch for your sanity? If you make it through the day, they will stamp your card and say, welcome to the land of the free. Well, my name is Rivka, and I came from Russia, where I never knew luxury. Then the Cossacks came with their swords and their guns. They killed all my family. So I came here where people don't live in fear, and I'll sweat in your dress shops all day. Torn, I see dreams reborn under island in New York Bay. Ellis Island, come down the gangplank, go through the door, stand on the long, long line. Do you have TB or a social disease? Do you have to hang your legs on friends? Do you have some relative there on the shore and vouch for yourself? If you make it through the day, they will stamp your card and say, welcome to the land of the free. My name is Guido, and I subways and I'll climb your buildings. I'll save up all of my pay so that next year my wife and my children can come to this island in New York Bay. We are the ghosts of old Ellis Island. We have our tales to tell. Some left a good life to come over here. Some left a living hell. But we crossed the sea and we built this land, as you will in your very own way. And to you who have come, we say, welcome home from this island in New York. Ellis Island, down the gangplank, over the door. If you make it through the day, they will stamp your card and say, welcome to the land of the free. If you make it through the day, they will stamp your card and say, welcome to the land of the free.
Great song, a great song.
Debbie, what's the name of the song?
Okay, it's called The Ghosts of Ellis Island, and it was written by Jan Christensen in 1986.
Yep.
Okay, then. Okay, so next, David, you just came in time. No, first Ron has to go. After Ron goes.
I'll pass for today. Move on to Dave.
Oh, I haven't really thought of a song. Let's see. God Save the Queen. I could do that.
Andy Hagen looks like he's got a guitar there ready to play.
Andy, are you going to perform?
That'd be great.
Okay. Andy was actually here before you, David, so I'm going to let Andy perform. Okay, and then Dave will go, and then I'm going to go. Okay.
Hi, guys.
Andy, let's hear you.
Hi, I'm Andy from Boca Raton, and I found out about this group on Facebook, and I just wanted to sit in this afternoon, and I loved it. It was so, all the songs were so great, and I like brought up back some memories, and although I'm a rock and roll kid, I really have gotten to appreciate folk music more, and as I've been writing music, I've been writing in that genre, so I hope you don't mind if I do something original.
Welcome to do anything you want.
Gently will you lay me in the hard ground. Slowly will you lower my old body down. Softly will you sing by my final resting place. Smiling as the sun touches your lovely face. Oh. Tuck me in my bed with shovels of soil. Reward me finally for a life of toil. Toss flower petals on the swelling earth. Shout a hallelujah for my second birth. When I'm gone, one regret will I have only dead for a season. You'll be lonely. Can we sit and share a glass of wine? We'll tell those stories one more time. time. He's in a better place, they will tell you. Well, of course we know that much is true. But it can't be heaven, oh my darling dear, till we both can share the glories here. When I'm gone, one regret have I only. For a season, you'll be lonely. Can we sit and share one more glass of wine? We'll tell the stories one more time. We shall meet on that beautiful shore, and our spirits shall sorrow no more. Clouds will part and the sun it will shine, and there you'll be forever mine. Gently will you lay me in the hard ground, slowly will you lower my old body down.
Welcome to the club.
Welcome.
You fit right in here. We hope you'll become a regular. Like to see you every week. Okay. David, are you ready?
Yeah.
By the way, one of your buddies was here last week and he sang your song, Hector Gilchrist. You know him?
Hector Gilchrist, yeah. Oh, beautiful singer.
Yeah, he was here last week and he sang one of your song about the Clydesdales.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he sang that one, did he?
Yes.
He's a lovely singer.
Yes.
Know him? Yeah. And anyway, I'll sing this. It was great to hear Jan's song, Ghost of Ellis Island song. You know, I sing with Jan in a group, loosely knit group known as the New York Packet. And I think we'll be singing together out on the port, whatever it is, on the North Shore of Long Island in a couple of weeks. Anyway, it was great to hear. And I'm going to sing you this little song. I think its origins are from the Caribbean, probably, anyway. I think it's from the Caribbean. The Ohana is rowing. Go row the boat, child. Johanna is rowing, go row the boat, child. Johanna is rowing, go row the boat, child. Go row the boat and let me go home. Your mama is calling. Go row the boat, child. Your mama is calling. Go row the boat, child. Your mama is calling.
Go row the boat, child. Go row the boat and let me go home. Lightning is flashing. Go row the boat, child. Lightning is flashing. Go row the boat, child. Lightning is flashing. Go row the boat, child. Go row the boat and let me go home. Storm clouds are forming. Go row the boat, child. Storm clouds are forming. Go row the boat, child. Storm clouds are forming. Go row the boat, child. Go row the boat and let me go home.
Yeah, nice one, David.
Great, thank you as always. Okay, I guess it's my turn now, and following David Jones and trying to do a seed shanty is not the easiest position to be in, especially since I just learned it last night. Okay, this is it's actually an African-American sea shanty, which was discovered by Stan Hugel and printed in his book, Shanties of the Seven Seas. And if not for Stan, we probably never would have known this. And it's called The Old Boat Picking on the Banjo. He bang, she bang, daddy shot a bear, shot it in the stern, me boys, and never turned a hair. We're from the railroad to Rello, and the old moke picking on the banjo. Chorus, hoorah, what the hell's the row? We're from the railroad to Rello, we're from the railroad to Rello, and the old moke picking on the banjo. Pat it back, taking your slack, heave away me boys, heave away me bully boys, and don't you make some noise. We're from the railroad to Rello, and the old moke picking on the banjo. Hoorah, what the hell's the row? We're from the railroad to Rello, we're from the railroad to Rello, and the old moke picking on the banjo. Roll her boys, pull her boys, give her flaming a kip, drag the anchor off the mud and let the bastard rip. We're from the railroad to Rello, we're from the railroad to Rello, and the old moke picking on the banjo. Hoorah, what the hell's the row? We're from the railroad to Rello, we're from the railroad to Rello, and the old moke picking on the banjo. Rock a block, chuck a block, heave the captain's round. Fish the flame and anchor up, for we are outward bound. We're from the railroad to Rello, and the old moke picking on the banjo. Hoorah, what the hell's the row? We're from the railroad to Rello, we're from the railroad to Rello, and the old moke picking on the banjo. Out shucks, two blocks, heave away our bust, bend your backs, me bully boys, and kick some flaming dust. We're from the railroad to Rello, and the old moke picking on the banjo. Hoorah, what the hell's the row? We're from the railroad to Rello, we're from the railroad to Rello, and the old moke picking on the banjo. Whiskey, oh, Johnny, oh, the mud hook is in sight. This is a hell of a way. Two of the gals that wait an old Nantucket light. We're from the railroad to Rollo, and the old mug picking on the banjo. Hoorah, what the hell's the row? We're from the railroad to Rollo. We're from the railroad to Rollo, and the old mug picking on the banjo.
We know that from Cliff Haslam from a long time ago.
I used to hear it at Mystic Secret, the finest festival that they ever had, but I don't know if it's going to continue. They said they don't have the money to keep it that way. So anyway, we finished one round, and we're going to go for the second round now. I want to tell Andy, everybody gets two turns. That's the way we work it. And we start at 2 o'clock, and when everyone gets two turns, that's the end of it. Okay, so Jerry, you started. We're going to start with you again, and we're going to go all around.
Okay. I got a call the other day. Things are opening up in their way, right? Like David mentioned that he's doing a festival out, I think, at Port Jefferson. I think I saw your name, David. There's a maritime festival coming up in Port Jefferson out here on Long Island, and I know that Mike and Bill have been doing some singing with the Hoy Shanty crew, and I got a call to play some mandolin and some guitar for a bluegrass gig in a couple of weeks. And so the guy who called said, listen, you know, bring a bunch of songs. I went, oh, crap. So I started digging out lyrics, and this is one of those tunes. It has a chorus. I'll teach you the chorus. It's very, very simple. The chorus goes, you can go and leave me if you wish to. Never let me cross your mind. If in your heart you love another, leave me, little darling, I don't mind. Columbus Stockade Blues, bluegrass standard. Anyway, it goes like this. Way down Columbus, Georgia, wanna go back in Tennessee. Way down Columbus Stockade, my friends all turn their backs on me. You can go and leave me if you wish to. Never let me cross your mind. If in your heart you love another, leave me, little darling, I don't mind. Many a night with you I've rambled. Many an hour with you I've spent. I thought you had your love forever. Now I find that it was only lent. You can go and leave me if you wish to. Never let me cross your mind. If in your heart you love another, leave me, little darling, I don't mind. Last night, as I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms. When I awoke, I was mistaken. I was gazing through these prison bars. You can go and leave me if you wish to. Never let me cross your mind. If in your heart you love another, you can leave me, little darling, I don't mind. Way down Columbus, Georgia, left me there to lose my mind. Thinking about my blue-eyed Sally, she's the little girl I left behind. You can go and leave me if you wish to. Never let me cross your mind. If in your heart you love another, leave me, little darling, I don't mind. Said you can't leave me, little darling, I don't mind. Thank you.
Great to hear you, Jerry.
Great to see you and hear you, Dave. It's been too long, my friend. Too long.
Jerry, if you're a cantor on Long Island, do you know the cantor that sings on JBS?
He's out in the Hamptons, right? The Hamptons Synagogue. Yeah, right. I've met him. Yeah, he's good. He's good.
Yeah, I heard him on TV on JBS like the night of Yom Kippur, and he was doing the ending, you know, of Yom Kippur. And
yeah, Nila.
Very good. And they also had a choir, you know, of people singing with their own conductor.
Yeah, they only let rich people into that synagogue.
Well, I got it virtually anyway.
There you go. Cool.
Okay, Javi and Pat, you're next.
So this song is Changes by Philux.
This is a song I've been playing almost as long as I've been playing guitar. And it's interesting because it's a breakup song, but it's a pretty breakup song. So until you get to the last verse, you may not realize it's a breakup song. Sit by my side, come as close as the air, sharing a memory of gray, and wonder in my words, dream about the pictures that I play of changes. Green leaves of summer turn red brown into yellow, they fade, and then they have to die, trapped within the circle time parade of changes. Scenes of my young years were warm in my mind. Visions of shadows that shine, till one day I returned, found they were the victims of the vines of changes. The world spinning madly, it drifts in the dark, swings through a hollow of haze, race around the stars, a journey through the universe ablaze of changes. Moments of magic will glow in the night, all fears of the forest are gone, but when the morning breaks, is swept away by golden drops of dawn of changes. Passions will part to a strange melody, as fires will sometimes burn cold, like petals in the wind. We're puppets to the silver strings of souls of changes. Your tears will be trembling now here somewhere else. One last cup of wine we will pour, and I'll kiss you one more time. Leave you on the rolling river shores of changes. So sit by my side, come as close as the air,
sharing a memory of grain, and wonder in my words, dream about the pictures that I play of changes.
What do you got for us today? The second selection.
Well, I decided to do a British vaudeville song. Always like to sing the odd ones.
Yes, you do.
It's called Removing Father's Grave.
Hold the sewer.
They're moving Father's grave to build a sewer. They're moving it regardless of expense. They're moving Dad's remains to lay down 9-inch drains to irrigate some posh dance residence. Now what's the use of having a religion if when you're dead you cannot get some peace? 'Cause some society chap wants a pipeline to his trap and moves you from your place of rest and peace. Now a father in his life was never. I'm sure he'll not be a quitter now. And in his winding sheet, he'll haunt that privy seat. He'll only let them sit when he'll allow. Well, won't there be some bleeding consternation? And won't those city toffs begin to rave? It's the one they deserve, for they had the bloody nerve to muck about with a British workman's grave.
You tell him, Harley.
I heard the Clancy brothers do that in Carnegie Hall. They got a rousing ovation.
Okay. I think that's the last time I heard it when we were in Carnegie Hall.
Yeah, you were with me that time, yeah.
Yeah, and the other song about changes also, I used to sing myself, but I haven't sung it in decades. Who was known for singing that song?
Phil Oakes wrote it.
Oh, Phil Oakes. Okay.
Yep, Phil Oakes is the only one. Well, I guess Gordon Lightfoot did a version of it too. It wasn't all that popular, but Oakes was the guy who wrote it, and his is the most popular version.
Ian and Sylvia did it too.
Pat Wichter also did it.
Yeah. Who?
Pat Wichter.
Oh, that one I don't know.
Yeah, he's did it recently. Okay, you're next, Murray. Everybody else, people.
Okay. I'm going to sing They're Moving Father's Grave to Build a Temple. No, I'm kidding. All right. Hold on a minute. Okay, this is another Ladino song. And I'll give you the English translation first. But anyway, Ladino, like I said, is from the Spanish of the late 15th century, early 16th century, 1400s, 1500s. And, you know, things have got, although they're still using Ladino, the Sephardic Jews, the Jews of Spanish origin, are still using it in this country and in Israel and in Greece or wherever they remain. They, you know, as any language, they adapt a lot of words from the country that they're living in. So they adapted Hebrew, they adapted English, everything in there. But it's mostly this Middle Ages Spanish. Okay, now this one is called La Rosa en Florece. That means the rose blooms, but it's also known as the nightingales, Los Bilbilicos. Sometimes it goes by one name, sometimes it goes by the other, and the stanzas get changed around somewhat. But anyway, in English it goes, the rose blooms in the month of May, my soul dark and suffering from love. They're always suffering from love. The nightingale sings, it sighs with love. Passion kills me. That's always happening in these romantic Spanish songs. It increases my pain. The nightingale sing in the flowering trees. Beneath them sit those who suffer from love. There they are again. Come more quickly, dove. Come faster with me. Come more quickly, my dear. Run and save me. Okay. So that's the English. Now the old Spanish goes like this. La rosa en florece en el mes de mayo. La rosa en florece en el mes de mayo. Mi alma se escurece sufriendo del amor. Mi alma se escurece sufriendo del amor. Los bilbilicos cantan, suspiran del amor. Los bilbilicos cantan, suspiran del amor. Y la pasión me mata, mucho igual mi dolor. Y la pasión me mata, mucho igual mi dolor. Los bilbilicos cantan en el árbol de la flor. Los bilbilicos cantan en el árbol de la flor. De bajo se asentan los que sufren del amor. De bajo se asentan los que sufren del amor. Más presto ven paloma, más presto ven coní. Más presto ven paloma, más presto ven coní. Más presto ven, querida, corre y sálvame. Más presto ven, querida, corre y sálvame. That's it.
To make the swallow song, if I'm correct. So, Murray, you muted the swallow song, Richard Farina. It was the same melody.
Yeah, that's right. I forgot about that. Yeah, that's Mimi Farina's husband. That's Joan Baez's sister. And her husband, did a song in the same melody.
Yeah. Okay, I believe Bob Winkler is next.
Okay. Well, I guess an answer to that, Murray.
Yeah.
It was next, Bob.
Yes.
A John Prine song. He's written about a lot of things. And this is a kind of a tongue-in-cheek song about the anti-love song about infidelity. Do you like me? Well, I hope you do. If you like me, then I think I'm gonna have to like you too. We'll share our things and have some fun. Then we'll say goodbye and go back home when the day is done. If you tell me, I'll tell you too. Then we'll say the things and do the things that lovers do. We'll keep it to ourselves. We won't hurt no one. Then we'll say goodbye and go back home when the day is done. We'll carve our names on a tree. Then we'll burn it down so no one in the world will see. We'll make love while we watch the flame. Then we'll walk away as if we never had no shame. We must hide to be alone, and we can't say our sweet things on the telephone. If we can't stop what we've begun, we should say goodbye and go back home when the day is done. Do you like me? I hope you do, 'cause if you still like me, then I think I'm going to have to still like you. We shared our things and had some fun. Now we'll say goodbye and go back home when the day is done. Yeah, we should say goodbye and go back home while we still have one. Say goodbye and go back home. Day is done. And we'll say goodbye and go back home while we still have one.
Water.
Very good. I've heard that one before. Me now?
Yeah, it's your turn now, Kathleen.
Right, this is a really sad song, and listening to Lonnie's song, I thought it's got everything that Lonnie's song says. It repeats itself over and over. It's a sort of a, I suppose it's a sort of a protest political song, but anyway, hasn't got 50 verses though, that's right. This is a song that I knew of when I was a teenager, and I still got my LP of Caroline Heston that I bought when I was about 16 or 17, and it's called the Jute Mill Song. And I didn't realise until sort of quite recently that it was actually a Scottish writer. The lady was Mary Brooksbank, and she was a worker in the mill, and she was a sort of, I don't know what you call it exactly, a sort of a workers' rights activist, and she belonged to the Communist Party and all sorts of things. So this is about the workers in the jute mill. Oh dear me, mill's running fast, poor we shifters gonna get their rest. Shifting bobbins, coarse and fine, they fairly make you work for your 10 and 9. Oh dear me, I wish the day was done, running up and down the pass gives me fun. Shifting, piecing, spinning, warp, weft and twine, to feed and play the bills of a 10 and 9. Oh dear me, the mill's running fast, poor we shifters gonna get their rest. Shifting bobbins, coarse and fine, we fairly make you work for your 10 and 9. Oh dear me, the world is ill divided, them that works the hardest are the least provided. But I'm one by contented, dark days are fine, there's no much pleasure living off a 10 and 9. Oh dear me, the mill's running fast, poor we shifters gonna get their rest. Shifting bobbins, coarse and fine, they fairly make you work for your 10 and 9. Oh dear. That the shifters got. The shifters were the people that moved the bobbins off of the machines and had to take them down to the end, apparently.
Okay, Bob and Susan.
Just Bob this time around.
I said I was doing some Beatles songs, still trying to do songs that I haven't done before. And it's been a long time that we've been doing this. I think my folder of songs, I'm still working on paper. My folder of songs is about 1.5 inches, 2 inches thick now. Anyway, here's a Beatles song, just a little one that I always like. Who knows how long I've loved you? You know I love you still. If I wait a lonely lifetime, if you want me to, I will. For if I ever saw you, I didn't catch your name, but it never really matters, I will always feel the same. Love you forever and forever, and love you with all my heart. Love you whenever we're together, love you when we're apart. And when at last I find you, your song will fill the air. Sing it loud so I can hear you, it easy to be near you. The things you do endear you to me, you know I will. Love you forever and forever, and love you with all my heart. Love you whenever we're together, and love you when we're apart. When at last I find you, your song will fill the air. Sing it loud so I can hear you, make it easy to be near you. For the things you do endear you to me, you know I will.
Okay, back to England, Mike Reeves.
Yeah, right. Martin did this on Tuesday, and we can't remember his surname, so I don't know whether Kathleen knows it. But anyway, this is one of the John Barleycorns. This is the one I like. The other one, John Barleycorn Must Die, I don't like. But anyway, John Barleycorn is a hero bold as any in the land. For ages good his fame has stood and shall forever stand. The whole world respects him, no matter friend or foe. And where they be that makes too free, he's sure to lay them low. Hey John Barleycorn, ho John Barleycorn, old and young thy praise have sung. John Barleycorn. To see him in his pride of growth, his robes are rich and green. His head is speared with prickly beard, fit nigh to serve the queen. And when the harvest time comes round and John is stricken down, he yields his blood for England's good and Englishman's renown. Hey, John Barleycorn, ho, John Barleycorn. Old and young thy praise have sung, John Barleycorn. The lord in courtly castle and the squire in stately hall, the great of name in birth or frame, on John for succour call. He bids the troubled heart rejoice, gives warmth to nature's cold, makes weak men strong and old ones young, and all men brave and bold. Hey John Barleycorn, ho John Barleycorn, old and young thy praise have sung, John Barleycorn. Then shout for great John Barleycorn, nor heed the luscious vine. I have no mind much charm to find in a potent draught of wine. Give me my native nut brown ale, all other drinks I'll scorn. For English cheer is English beer, and our own John Barleycorn. Hey, John Barleycorn, ho, John Barleycorn, old and young thy praise have sung, John Barleycorn. Good round for you.
I like that version.
Yeah. Okay, Bill.
Yeah. Right. So I had another song request yesterday, or one of these, you know, when people get hold of you and say, why don't you write a song about that? Oh, I had another one on him yesterday. I've not had one of them for a little while. It was normally people like Charlie Skelton sending messages on the Zoom meeting, wasn't it? But yeah, it was about a mutual acquaintance who we don't see very much of. And they keep popping up on a daily basis on all sorts of social media platforms, and everything they do and say is all about themselves, but we just don't recognize this person that they keep portraying all the time. So it was something along that basis anyway. And if I do it now, it most likely never get done again because I'll alter it by the time I need it next week. But we'll see what happens anyway. I am my alter ego, I'm no longer me. My internet appearance is all that you can see. I am my alter ego, I think I must agree. My alter ego's taken over who I used to be. I'm a social media person with a social media plan. Please make sure you visit me as often as you can. I'm desperate for attention, I want all that I can get. I'm the best of friends with all these people that I've never met. Well, they all like to follow me, they think that I'm a star. And they all recognise me by my online avatar. Snapchat, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, Twitter. If you don't send me lots of likes, then I get sad and bitter. I am my alter ego, I'm no longer me. My internet appearance is all that you can see. I am my alter ego, I think I must agree. My alter ego's taken over who I used to be. I say nice things to everyone, my charm is wide and free. But it's on the understanding they say nice things back to me. But if I'm in the real world for one reason or another, I pretend it's a rehearsal for Celebrity Big Brother. American edition, most likely. I commentate upon my life like a TV documentary and make sure that I leave out anything uncomplimentary. And when I talk about myself, it's always in third person. It makes me look important in my public self-assertion. I am my alter ego. I'm no longer me. My internet appearance is all that you can see. I am my alter ego, I think I must agree. My alter ego's taken over who I used to be. I fill my page with selfies from every different place, but all of them are close-ups of my stupid selfie face. I'm running out of things to say and new stuff I can do. And you won't want to know me if I can't do something new. And now no one sees my blogs and vlogs or cares about my status. And the only comments these days are all coming from the haters. I think it's true when people say pride comes before a fall. And when my alter ego dies, I won't exist at all. I am my alter ego. I'm no longer me. My internet appearance is all that you can see. I am my alter ego. I think I must agree. My alter ego's taken over who I used to be. Now my social media glory is all coming to an end. So if I ask you nicely, please, will you be my friend? I am my alter ego. I'm no longer me. My alter ego's taken over who I used to be.
Very good, Bill. You can always post pictures of what you had for dinner or your cat.
That's nobody in our circle, I must say. It's not referring to any of us. We're all far too nice for that.
Send out the lyrics.
Actually, I've got another verse or two, but they're getting quite rude, so I stopped writing. I'm not going to do any more verses.
Okay, Steve Einden, You have your favorite chair ready?
Yes.
Okay. You're on the air.
Actually, my favorite chair is not my guitar-friendly chair. It's the other one. This is a Paul Simon song. And the other day I saw a video of Simon back with Garfunkel in concert doing it. Slip sliding away, slip sliding away. You know the near destination no more, slip sliding away. I know a man, he came from my hometown. He wore his passion for his woman like a thorny crown. He said, Dolores, I live in fear. My love for you is so empowering, I'm afraid that I will disappear. Slip sliding away, slip sliding away. You know the nearer destination, the more slip sliding away. I know a woman became a wife. These are the very words she uses to describe her life. She says a good day ain't got no rain. She says a bad day's when I lie in bed and think of things that might have been. Slip sliding away, slip sliding away. You know the nearer destination, the more slip sliding away. And I know a father who had a son. He longed to tell him all the reasons for the things he'd done. He came a long way just to explain. He kissed his boy as he lay sleeping, then he turned around and headed home again. Slip sliding away, slip sliding away. You know the nearer destination, the more slip sliding away. God only knows. God makes his plans. The information's unavailable to the mortal man. We're working our jobs, collect our pay. Believe we're gliding down the highway when in fact we're slip sliding away. Slip sliding away. Slip sliding away. You know the nearer destination, the more slip sliding away. Whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Okay, next, I believe, is Lonnie. Lonnie, you on
the- I'm here. We're having a terrible thunderstorm out here, so if I go away whilst doing this, it's not my fault. I'm going to do something on the piano. This is an Irish tune, and it was written by a fellow I like quite a bit, Chris DeBerg. And Wendy's has gotten some very nice pictures for us that she's going to be going in on OBS. And here we go.
You lost your audio, Ronnie. We can't hear you. Nice pictures, but no audio. No sound at all.
Too much for this to 1930 triple off.
We don't hear you at all. Ronnie, we can't hear you. You have no sound.
Yeah, this storm is breaking everything up. We're going to have to pass on this. Go ahead with somebody else. The power's out.
I'm just singing without the other stuff. Okay. Can
hear them now. Yeah, could you maybe take a guitar and sing out the other stuff? So why should you lose a turn?
I can try.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, I actually. Yeah, we had to get everything up and running again after the power went down, and something is wrong with something in here. So are you able to hear? Wait.
Yes, we hear you.
Can you hear that?
Yeah.
You can hear that, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we can hear you. Yep.
I never used to miss the chance to climb upon his knee and listen to the many tales of life upon the sea. We'd go sailing back on Barkentine, talk of things he did. Life was just a day away for the captain and the kid. His world had gone from sailing ships to wrecking mom's backyard. He never could adjust to land, although he tried so hard. We're both growing older then and wiser with our years. That's when I came to understand when the course is hard, you still steer. He died about a month ago, all winter filled the air. And though I cried, I was so proud to love a man so rare. Somewhere on the ocean now, in a place he ought to be. One hand on the starboard rail, he's waving back at me. I never used to miss the chance to climb upon his knee and listen to the many tales of life upon the sea. We'd go sailing back on barkentines and we'd talk of things he did. Life was just a day away for the captain and the kid. For the captain and this kid. right.
It was nothing.
Yeah, fine.
Thank you very much. I do appreciate that.
Okay. Debbie, I think you're next. Rhonda's going to sing or he's going to pass again?
I'll pass.
Passing today.
Yeah.
Oh. Is he all right? Is Ron okay? Because he's not done anything.
Yeah. He's just not doing it
is
today.
Is he all right?
Next week, he'll be back.
Oh.
Take a rest a little. He's entitled to it. Okay, I think that brings us to David, right?
Me?
Yeah, you, yeah. You're the only David.
Oh, wow. All right. All right. I'll sing a little Ed Harrigan song. Ed Harrigan sort of founded the Irish Music Hall in the 19th century in New York, and he really pioneered the whole Broadway scene. He was a big influence on George M. Cohen, you know. H-A-O-O-I-G-A-N spells Harrigan. And Mick Maloney has sort of revived his music, putting out a bunch of splendid recordings of Ed Harrigan's work. This one is called Mrs. Murphy's Home. Down by Hogan's Alley, at the dawning of the day, I lived with my old mother and heard the people's nips. Now, that's the last verse. Let's start with the first verse. It's usually the order. I'll just sing the chorus, see if that leads me into it. On Sunday night, it's my delight and pleasure, don't you see, to welcome all the boys and girls that work downtown with me. There's an organ in the parlor to give the house some tone, and you're welcome every evening at Maggie Murphy's home. There's waltzing in the parlor, there's a dance for you and I, there's kissing in the corner and coddling on the sly. God bless these leisure hours that working people know. And you're welcome every evening at Maggie Murphy's home. On Sunday night, 'tis my delight and pleasure, don't you see, to welcome all the boys and girls that work downtown with me. There's an organ in the parlor to give the house some tone, and you're welcome every evening at Maggie Murphy's home. Behind the grammar schoolhouse, there's a double tenement where I lived with my old mother and always paid the rent. A bedroom and a parlor, it was all we had to own. But you're welcome every evening at Maggie Murphy's home. On Sunday night, 'tis my delight and pleasure, don't you see, to welcome all the boys and girls that work downtown with me. There's an organ in the parlor to give the house some tone, and you're welcome every evening at Maggie Murphy's home. Down by Hogan's Alley, at the dawning of the day, I'd go with my old mother to hear what people say. There goes that little Maggie, how I wish she was my own. And you're welcome every evening at Maggie Murphy's home. On Sunday night, It's my delight and pleasure, don't you see, to welcome all the boys and girls that work downtown with me. There's an organ in the parlor to give the house some tone, and you're welcome every evening at Maggie Murphy's home.
Sounds crowded there.
It occurs to me that this is this what we do here is like a modern version of the of singing around the piano in the Victorian times.
Right, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Except we don't have a piano.
No. Money does.
Money, yeah.
It didn't work.
Okay. I guess now I do the penultimate. And as usual, Jerry, we're going to prevail upon you to do the ultimate. Okay. So, no, we don't need hats for this. Okay, in the history of the United States, there were two presidents that were bachelors that weren't married. One of them was James Buchanan, who preceded Lincoln, who was immediately before Lincoln, and the other one was Theodore Roosevelt. Now, Theodore Roosevelt, both of them had their nieces, you know, be first ladies, and.
Wait a minute. Theodore Roosevelt was married twice.
Yeah, but when he was in the White House, he didn't have a first lady.
Maybe for a short time.
He did. I think you're thinking of Grover Cleveland when he was sworn in the first time. He was a bachelor. Then he was married in the White House.
Yeah, but.
Grover Cleveland was the only president to serve two non-consecutive terms.
Right.
Well, anyway, Alice Longworth was, according to Wikipedia, said that she was the first lady for a while for Teddy, his niece. And there's a song associated with Alice Longworth called Alice Blue Gown. And yeah. My mother used to sing it to me all the time.
My mother, too.
Yeah, I think it was from a Broadway play originally. And here it goes. In my sweet little Alice blue gown, when I first wandered down into town, I was both proud and shy as I felt every eye. But in every shop window I primped passing by. Then in manner of fashion I'd frown, and the world seemed to smile all around, till it wilted, I wore it, I'll always adore it, my sweet little Alice blue gown. But in manner of fashion I'd frown, and the world seemed to smile all around, till it wilted, I wore it, I'll always adore it, my sweet little Alice blue gown. Okay. starts his last song. I just want to tell everybody the link is the same for next week and for the next 5 weeks after that. Okay, I keep reminding everybody, but please save the link, because for those of you who may miss the email or something, this is the link for the next 5 weeks. We will be here, even though this is the time of the Jewish holidays, none of them take place on a Sunday, so we will be here, God willing, every week, okay, at 2 o'clock, 7 o'clock for our friends in the UK. Jerry, it's all up to you now.
All right. So the very first time I heard this song, I heard it on Pete Seeger's show on Channel 13 here in New York. he had a show that was a 15-minute show called The Rainbow Quest. I loved that show. You couldn't hear stuff like that anywhere else. So, and he had everybody on. He had Judy Collins and Joan Baez was on, and the Greenbrier Boys were on, and Reverend Gary.
The Corsoi Sisters?
Yes, the Corsoi Sisters. He had on Mississippi John Hurt, and he had on Reverend Gary Davis, and he had on Sonny Terry and Brownie McGee. And they did this tune, and I kind of went, wow, that's really cool. And this tune has been done by everybody except me. So I haven't done it, but I have the lyrics here. So it's not that complicated. So I'm going to do this tune, and it was actually I think composed. I think Lonnie said this one week. He didn't compose it. He made it up, right? So I think this was made up by Big Bill Brunsey, I think, but who knows. I got the key to the highway, built out and bound to go. I'm gonna leave here running, cause walking's most too slow. I'm going back to the border, where I'm better known. Cause you haven't done nothing but drove a good man away from home. Give me one more kiss, mama, just before I go. Cause when I'm leaving here, I won't be back no more. When the moon peeps over the mountain, honey, I'll be on my way. I'm gonna walk this highway until the break of day. Well, it's so long, baby, I must say goodbye. I'm gonna roam this highway until the day I die. Sure as the sun keeps shining in the skies up above, I'm gonna walk this highway till I find me someone to love. I woke up this morning, put on my highway shoes. Didn't take me long till I had those highway blues. I'm going out on the highway, that Greyhound bus had gone. Started thinking about that girl, sure be walking alone. Now I know that Sonny Terry probably came up with this, or Brownie McGee. Been around the Gold Gates, California, to the rocky shores of Maine. Been on that highway so long, highway's my middle name. I'll eat my breakfast right here in New York City. Could get my dinner in New Orleans. I'm the highway walkingest man this world has ever seen. Well now, so long, people, I'll soon say goodbye. I'll roam this highway till the day I die. I got the key to the highway. I'm built out and bound to go. Gonna leave this highway running, cause walking's most too slow. I'm gonna leave this highway running, cause walking's most too slow.
Everybody next week.
Hey folks, drive safely.
Okay.
Everybody stay safe. Stay safe.
That are your golden thread.
Yes.
Eagle so fine.
With his little banjo thing going in the back. Oh, yeah. It was a great show. It was a great show.
Oh, yeah.
Man. Fabulous. He had on everybody. He had on the Stanley Brothers. I mean, it was amazing. It was an amazing little show. I don't know how he got away with it. I don't...
The thing is, you've still got lots and lots of it coming up on YouTube all the time.
All the time. Yeah, they're great sessions. I mean, they're great sessions because you could literally, certainly here in New York, many of those people you would never have seen ever, or except in a festival or something. But boy, it was great exposure. Great. Mm. You know, very important.
Okay.
Good to see everybody.
Take care, y'all. Y'all come back now, you hear?
I see you late next week. See y'all. Hardy, thanks for recording. This will have it probably in 2-3 hours or so.
We may be missing next week. We are performing to see at the end of South End Pier, so God knows what time we'll get back from there. But if we're not here, it'll be because the pier has broken away and is sailing out into the North Sea somewhere. Nice to see you anyway. Yeah.
If you're there, then hold on to that wood.
That's it. Okie doke. Bye bye.
Good night, everybody.
Good point, Bill.